Let us start a carbonyl compounds. Carbonyl compounds is what in the sense aldehydes, ketones. Aldehydes and ketones are called carbonyl compounds. Now, how to prepare aldehydes and ketones? That we will see. One method is oxidizing alcohol. Oxidation of alcohol results aldehydes and ketones. Primary alcohols on oxidation gives aldehyde. Secondary alcohols on oxidation gives ketone. Okay, this is one method. Another method is alcohol on dehydrogenation gives a carbonyl compound. Primary alcohol on dehydrogenation gives aldehyde. Secondary alcohol on dehydrogenation gives ketone. What is the reagent in the sense? Copper at 573 Kelvin. Okay. Now we will see manufacture of some aldehyde. Particular aldehyde we will see. One we will take methanol. Methanol is treated with, is heated with catalyst silver or copper. What we are getting in the sense? Formaldehyde we are getting. That means it goes for dehydrogenation. H2 will be removed. We are getting formaldehyde. Then methanol is treated with oxygen gas in the presence of copper catalyst. What we are getting in the sense? Formaldehyde and water. That means from here hydrogen and this oxygen removed as water. So we are getting formaldehyde. Next method is methane with oxygen in the presence of metal oxide catalyst. We are getting formaldehyde. And water. Okay. Sir. Next, we'll go for a naming reaction. Naming reaction is what in the sense? Rosenmans reduction. We will take Rosenmans reduction, Okay, Rosenmans reduction. In this Rosenmans reduction, what is the catalyst we are doing? We are taking in the sense finely divided palladium. Finely divided palladium is acting as a catalyst. Finely divided in the sense, take palladium in a powder form. That is called finely divided, we'll say. Why we have to take finely divided? Why we have to take powder form? Because surface area will be more. That's it for that case. Okay. So catalyst is finely divided palladium. And here we have to add catalytic poison. We have to add. What is the catalytic poison in the sense? Barium sulfate plus sulfur. Other, instead of sulfur, we can take quinoline also. So catalytic poison we added. Then solvent. Solvent is a xylene. This xylene is taken at its boiling temperature. It is taken. Sir. So what this Rosenmans reduction will do? It converts acid halide. It converts acid halide into aldehyde. It is called acid halide. X in the sense CLBRI we can take. Acid halide into aldehyde it will do. Then this Rosenmans reduction, this reagent will convert CC triple bond into CC double bond. That addition is a syn addition. That means we will get cis isomer. That means CC triple bond is converting into CC double bond. That means Lindler's catalyst is there, no? Lindler's catalyst will do what? CC triple bond into CC double bond, cis isomer we will get. Lindler's catalyst means CC double bond we will get, cis isomer we will get. Like this, okay? So, now we will take some reactants. We will take acetaldehyde we are taking. That means, sorry, acid chloride. What is the acid chloride? Means CH3COCl is the acid chloride. To this this we will take for Rosenmans reduction. What will happen means COCl will convert into aldehyde. Okay. Suppose we are taking benzoyl chloride. We are taking this for Rosenmans reduction. What will happen means Cl will be replaced by H. So we will get a benzaldehyde. We are getting benzaldehyde. Okay. So now we will take the reactant. Here triple bond we have taken. Here we will take a CO, C double bond O, Cl. We have taken so and so reactant. We will take this reactant for Rosenmans reduction. What will happen? Rosenmans reduction in the sense, this Cl will be replaced by H. Okay. Cl will be replaced by H. Then this CC triple bond will be converted into CC double bond. This CC triple bond will be converted into CC double bond and it will become cis isomer. Okay. So CC double bond, cis isomer, write two hydrogens in the same side. This methyl group we will write here. This CH2 group we will write here and COH we will write here. Okay. This Cl is replaced by H. So Rosenmans reduction in the sense CC triple bond is converted into CC double bond. Syn addition, we can say. Next, we will take a formyl chloride. We will take this is what in the sense formyl chloride. This is a formyl chloride, we can say. This formyl chloride is a taken for Rosenmans reduction. We will get what in the sense formaldehyde will take. That means Cl will be replaced by H. But this method we cannot use for preparing formaldehyde. Why? Because formyl chloride is unstable at room temperature. At room temperature, formyl chloride is unstable. Therefore, we cannot use this method. We cannot use this method for preparing formaldehyde cell. Now, we will take a next point. We will take now acid halide. We are taking acid halide. This acid halide we will convert into aldehyde. We are converting acid halide into aldehyde. For which, what is the reducing agent we can use? What is the reducing agent we can use? One is called DBAH. DBAH we can use. What is DBAH in the sense? D in the sense of di. B in the sense isobutyl. Isobutyl. A in the sense aluminium, aluminium, H in the sense hydride, H in the sense hydride. Di isobutyl aluminium hydride is the reducing agent. This will convert acid halide into aldehyde. Sir, if you take benzyl chloride, if you take benzyl chloride, this reducing agent will replace Cl by H. Therefore, we will get benzaldehyde, we will get. We will get benzaldehyde. Okay. Next method of prepare. Next method we'll see. Now we'll take acid halide. We are taking acid chloride. We will add dialkyl cadmium. Dialkyl cadmium we are adding. What we are getting in the sense? We are getting ketone. Acid halide. Acid chloride with the dialkyl cadmium gives what in the sense ketone cell. Acid chloride I will take. Acid chloride I am taking like this. Acid chloride I have taken like this. Dialkyl cadmium I will take. Dialkyl cadmium I have taken. Now, what happens means CDCl2 goes away. This bond is shifting towards R. This R minus is attacking this CO. So this bond is shifting like this. This bond is shifting here. This R minus is attacking this C. This bond is shifting here. Okay. Therefore, what we will get in the sense R, CO, R dash. Ketone will get. Two times we will get. Then CDCl2 we will get. Cadmium chloride we are getting. Okay. So now we will see. CH3COCl. It is the acid halide, acid chloride. Okay. Dialkyl cadmium is what in the sense? Mu2Cd. So what is the product we will get? That means the CH3CO takes this Me and becomes what in the sense? Acetone. We will get acetone is the product. You will get acetone. Okay. So next we will see. Next one is what is that means? Catalytic decomposition of carboxylic acid. Catalytic decomposition. Catalytic decomposition of carboxylic acid will see. Catalytic decomposition of carboxylic acid results what in the sense carbonyl compounds. Okay. Now we'll take formic acid. This is treated with catalyst MnO. Catalyst is MnO we are taking. Then temperature we are placing 575 Kelvin. Okay, we have taken formic acid. Catalyst is MnO. Temperature is 575 Kelvin. What happens means it undergoes a decomposition. Sir, how the decomposition will be there? That we'll see. We have taken formic acid like this. We are taking formic acid in this way. So what is removed? You see that this is one. This bond is shifting. This bond is shifting. Attacking here. Okay. So this bond is shifting here. Therefore, what we are getting in the sense, this is water. This is carbon dioxide. This is what in the sense. This is what you see that. This formaldehyde. Okay. That is formaldehyde. So you got formaldehyde. So formic acid on catalytic decomposition in the presence of catalyst MnO at temperature 575 Kelvin gives what compound in the sense? Formaldehyde is the compound. Sir, okay. Next reaction we'll see. Now we'll take acetic acid. Acetic acid we'll take. What is the catalyst in the sense? MnO is the catalyst. MnO is the catalyst. Temperature is how much in the sense? 575 Kelvin. What is the product we'll get? Okay, we'll check. Acetic acid we'll write. Acetic acid we are writing. Acetic acid. Now, how the bond shift takes place, we'll see. Now, this bond is shifting here. This bond is shifting here. This bond is attacking here. This bond is shifting here. Okay. Therefore, what is the product we'll get? CH3COCH3. Acetone we are getting. Then carbon dioxide and water. Okay. So, next reaction we'll see. Next reaction, what in the sense? Acetic acid plus formic acid. Okay, MnO catalyst, 575 Kelvin. What is the product we will get? That we will see. Here, do we get one product or mixture of products? That means, now see, acetic acid involving means acetone is one product. Formic acid involving in the sense formaldehyde is one product. Okay, so one product is what? Acetic acid is involving means acetone. Formic acid involving means formaldehyde. Okay. What is the another possibility that we'll see? So now we'll take acetic acid. Then we'll take formic acid. Then we have taken formic acid. What will happen? We'll see here. Now. Okay, so what we are getting in the sense CH3COCOH acetaldehyde we are getting. Okay, acetaldehyde we are getting. So mixture of products we are getting in that one is acetaldehyde we are getting earlier. Okay, so next reaction we'll see. Now acetic acid, propionic acid. Here catalyst is MnO, temperature is 575 Kelvin. So what is the product? Acetic acid will give acetone. Acetic acid will give acetone. Propionic acid will give C2H5COCH5. Okay. What is the another product that we'll see? This acetic acid will write like this. Propionic acid will write like this. Propionic acid. Now bond shift we will see. Bond shift. Okay. Therefore we will get CTH5COCH3. This product we are getting. That means mixture of products we are getting. If formic acid is there. Now you see that formic acid is giving formaldehyde. acetic acid is giving ketone. Okay, formic acid is, that means aldehyde is obtained. Acetic acid is giving ketone. Here also formic acid is there, that's why we got aldehyde. So if you want aldehyde, you must take formic acid. If you take not formic acid, if the carboxylic acid is not formic acid, then we will get only ketone. If formic acid is there, then only we will get aldehyde. If formic acid is there, then only we will get aldehyde. Otherwise, we will not get aldehyde. Okay. So formic acid means aldehyde is possible. Other than formic acid means we will get ketone. Okay. Next. We'll see. Dry distillation of calcium salts, dry distillation of calcium salts of fatty acids. Okay, dry distillation of calcium salts of fatty acids, you'll see. Okay, calcium salts are fatty acids in the sense carboxylic acids. Fatty acids in the sense carboxylic acids. Treat carboxylic acids with calcium hydroxide, you will get calcium salt of fatty acid. Okay, just carboxylic acid you treat with calcium hydroxide, you will get calcium salt of fatty acid. You will get, now we will get, take a calcium acetate, we'll take, we are taking a calcium acetate. To this, what this calcium acetate is taken, this calcium acetate is taken for dry distillation, that means it is heated. It is heated. So this on heating gives what, we will see. Okay. So calcium acetate will take CH3, CO, then this O minus, again CH3, CO, O minus, and calcium. Okay. Here what happens? You see that here we are getting a calcium carbonate. And what is another substance in the sense? CH3, CO, CH3. We are getting acetone. So calcium acetate on dry distillation. Calcium acetate on dry distillation gives what in the sense? Acetone. Okay. So calcium acetate on dry distillation gives acetone. Okay. Now, next we will take a calcium formate. We will take calcium formate. We are taking calcium formate. Calcium formate on dry distillation we'll take. So, calcium formate we can write like this.